Ferrari SF90 Stradale Review. But before we start, please support us by pressing the like and subscribe buttons, so that we can continue to provide information about car and motorcycle news. Also, turn on the bell button to get the latest updates. Your support means a lot to us. Thank you. Viewed through the great prism of electrification by which the automobile is currently framed, the subject of this week's road test, the SF90 Stradale, would seem to be most significant, because it's the first plug-in hybrid model to be launched by the world's defining purveyor of supercars of all shapes and sizes, Ferrari. But while it is accurate to think of it like that, this car has much greater and wider reaching ambitions than simply to make the modern mid-engined Ferrari concept more responsible, more sustainable and more socially conscious. SF90 is the first mid-engine Ferrari since the 360 Modena to depart from that car's proportions. It's longer in the wheelbase and more cabin forward, with a shorter nose and overhangs, less classic but not unappealing. Make no mistake about it, the SF90 is out to totally reinvent the technical rulebook that has governed the way in which Maranello has designed and executed so many of its cars over the past 30 years. It uses electrification innovatively and with real commitment in an attempt to surpass any dynamic expectation you might have of it, and not just to ace a lab emissions test or to keep the combustion engine Ferrari alive for another decade or so. And that commitment, as you're about to find out, becomes manifest in some pretty spectacular ways when you seek to gauge it with satellite timing gear. The SF90 is billed by its maker as a paradigm shift for the supercar, something extreme on every level. And rather than some super rare collector's item or a fleeting special series halo model, it becomes a long-term addition to the firm's showroom range. With this car, Ferrari has put a V8 engine in its Top Dog series production model for the first time in 72 years. This is also the first four-wheel drive sports car in Maranello's history, if we count the FF and GTC4 Lusso as Grand Tourers. It also comes at a time of wider renewal for the brand of the Prancing Horse, with a line of mid-engine V8 models that started with the 360 Modena of 1999 and culminated with the Ferrari F8 Tributo of 2019 about to bow out and the all-new 296 GTB V6 Hybrid set to succeed them. We're on the cusp of a new electrified era for one of the world's most revered car makers, then. Time to find out how it begins. The SF90 lineup at a glance. Ferrari offers the SF90 enclosed roof Stradale and convertible spider body styles, the latter priced more expensively than the former and nudging through the £400,000 barrier. The most significant optional feature is the Assetto Fiorano specification, which can be had on either body and adds uprated dampers, extra weight-saving body panels and suspension hardware, a larger rear wing and sticky Michelin Pilot Sport Cup 2 tires. It will add just under £40,000 to your car's price. Other key options that might also be considered trim levels in their own right include carbon fiber wheels, £19,200, carbon fiber bucket seats, £5,760, and two-tone striped paintwork, £20,160. The SF90, named in reference to its debut in the 90th anniversary year of the creation of Enzo Ferrari's ex-works Alfa Romeo racing team in 1929, is based on a monocoque chassis tub built just over the road from Ferrari's Maranello factory, by the company's wholly owned Scaglietti Coachworks subsidiary. The chassis is of an entirely new design. It uses hollow aluminium castings and consists of new lightweight aluminium alloys and a carbon fiber rear bulkhead. It's 20% stiffer in bending and 40% more torsionally rigid than any comparable tub that the company has used before, but it's no heavier. Active aero includes what Ferrari calls a shut-off gurney flap under the rear wing. When extra downforce is needed during cornering or braking, this surface flips down, creating drag but boosting the effectiveness of the aerofoil above. The car's powertrain consists of a redesigned and enlarged F-154 family, mid-mounted, twin-turbocharged 770 bhp V8 engine, 3 AC synchronous electric drive motors and a 7.9 kWh lithium-ion drive battery, along with some very sophisticated power control electronics. The biggest and most powerful of those motors, the motor generator unit, kinetic in Ferrari speak, is a three-phase axial flux motor sandwiched between the car's V8 engine and its 8-speed dual-clutch automatic gearbox. That it's said to be derived from the matching component in Ferrari's current Formula One car says all you need to know about the way in which technology can still transfer from racetrack to road, even from the very highest reaches of motorsport. It makes up to 201 bhp all on its own, but there are two more drive motors, radial flux, rated for a combined 266 bhp between them, mounted in the front of the car, which drive the front wheels through independent promoter transmissions and which form a fully asymmetrical torque vectoring electric front axle.
Thanks for watching. Drop a like, leave a comment, and don't forget to subscribe to watch more videos like this.